Hi, I'm Scott Noonan, the CEO of Audio Advice. This video is part of our home theater design series that goes over almost everything about designing a home theater. Adding a subwoofer to your home stereo system or home theater system can make a huge improvement in your sound if you know how to properly position the subwoofer and adjust all of the settings. If you're willing to spend just a little bit of time learning how to set up a subwoofer the right way, the addition can transform your system. The main reason people add a subwoofer is the obvious one. You will normally get deeper and more bass output. What you may not realize, however, is that adding a subwoofer can also improve the mid-range and treble definition of your main speakers. In addition to our world-class home theater design tool, we've given you everything you need to begin your home theater journey in the Audio Advice Home Theater Central at audioadvice.com. You can find the link in the description. Where you sit and where you place your subwoofer will have a tremendous impact on the ultimate sound. If you have not watched our video on subwoofer placement, please watch that first before proceeding to the steps I describe next. This video is all about how to properly set up and calibrate your subwoofer once you have it generally placed in your home theater. With home theaters becoming so popular and great bass being an essential part of it, you will notice there are a large variety of subwoofers on the market to choose from. At one extreme are basic models with simple connections, and at the other are subwoofers with complete room correction built in. Some even have an app to help you fine-tune your subwoofer from your listening chair. In this video, I'm going to cover how the setup process applies for the different types of subwoofers. First, there are some basic things about connecting up your subwoofer you should do. Every home theater receiver or processor has one or more subwoofer output jacks. You will want to use an RCA or XLR cable to run from the subwoofer out on your receiver to your sub. If you have two subwoofers, it is ideal if your receiver has two subwoofer outputs, but you can still get the benefit of two subs with just one sub output on your receiver. Simply use a high-quality Y connector to split the signal and run two cables from there. Most subwoofers also have a left and right input. For home theater, you do not have to worry about this and can just connect to either one. The only exception would be if your sub has one of them labeled LFE, in which case you would use that connection. A few subwoofers have both input and output connections. Make sure you're connecting to the ones labeled input. While you are behind your subwoofer, you will probably see it as a knob for a level control. Most subs just set this at about 12 o'clock. Also, if your subwoofer has a phase switch or dial, set it to zero. Another thing that is critical is to make sure you're not using two crossovers. The crossover is the electronic circuit that sends the low bass tones to the subwoofer and the rest of the sounds to your other speakers. Almost all home theater receivers have subwoofer crossovers built in, and almost all subwoofers have a crossover on the back of the sub. You do not want to accidentally cross things over twice. I find it best to use the crossover in your home theater receiver and then disable or bypass the crossover at the subwoofer. Make sure you connect to the bypass input on your subwoofer. Some subwoofers will have two sets of inputs with one labeled bypass and the other labeled crossover. Others will have just one set of inputs with a small toggle switch where you select bypass or crossover. Before you start listening, you will also want to make sure your settings are correct on your home theater receiver or processor. Your receiver will have a section in the menu where you can tell the system if you have a subwoofer and where you want to cross it over. Some receivers give you a choice of large or small, where others give you frequency settings. It is best to start out with all of your speakers set to small, or if you have crossover adjustments, set them all to 80 Hertz. The next step is to make sure your distances are entered into your home theater receiver. Use a tape measure to find the distance each speaker is from your main listening spot and enter that into the settings. You may change these later for the subwoofer, but for now, use what you measure. Now for a critical tech tip. If your subwoofer comes with a microphone and/or has an app or is wireless, it has digital processing inside that will delay the signal coming out of the subwoofer. Most subwoofers like this have a delay of around 8 to 12 milliseconds. A millisecond translates into about 1 foot of distance. If your sub has a built-in digital processor, this means you will need to add, on average, 10 feet or so to your distance setting at this stage before you start listening to better align the signals reaching your ears from your subwoofer and main speakers. This only applies to subwoofers with room EQ built in, app control, or wireless. I will go over how to fine-tune this distance in the phase setup. The last step is to do a rough level settings adjustment. There are a variety of decent apps on the market for smartphones that will let you measure SPL, sound pressure level. You can easily download one on your iOS or Android device. I like SPL Meter from Studio 6. Turn the test tones on and match the levels up using the meter on your phone. In most cases, you will set the levels of all your speakers to 75 dB. If you have multiple subs, for each additional sub, set your level about 3 dB lower since they need to combine to be 75 dB. All right, so one tech tip. When you're using the SPL meter on your phone, what you want to do is actually take off your cover because it's blocking the microphone, and then actually turn the phone upside down so to get the microphone in the best place. If you have not watched my video on subwoofer placement, please do so before proceeding with the next step. You'll want to first place your subwoofer or subwoofers in the best spots possible in the room, and then move on to sub EQ calibration, which I'm going to cover next. If you are lucky enough to have a subwoofer with auto calibration, it is now the time to do that step. If not, you will just skip to the next step. Your subwoofer will come with instructions on how to do this. Normally, there will be a calibrated microphone and stand you will connect up either to a computer or the sub. Just follow the steps and let the subwoofer calibration do its own thing. There are a few subwoofers on the market that have manual room EQ on the rear of the sub. To use these, you will need to use some more advanced audio tools, as you will need to know at what frequency the peaks are occurring in your room. You will play some test tones through the subwoofer to visually see the peaks, then try to take them down by reducing the same or close frequency on the back of the sub. I don't suggest you try to take out dips by boosting the EQ controls on the rear. Trying a different position in the room for the subwoofer is a better idea. For the best experience, you want the sound from your main speakers and subwoofer to arrive at your ears at the exact same time. This is what phase adjustments can do. This adjustment is a bit technical, and you can skip it if you're more of a casual listener. However, when you do get the phase match between your subs and main speakers, you get this sense of effortless sound that is pretty amazing. If your home theater receiver or processor has Dirac or Anthem room correction, it will do this step for you. Lucky you. There are a small handful of subwoofers on the market that give you the ability to adjust the phase from 0 to 180 with everything in between, either with a knob on the rear of the sub or an app that allows you to do the adjustments. Changing the distance in your surround sound receiver will also adjust phase. I actually find it easiest to just change the distance in your home theater receiver or processor versus changing the phase on the subwoofer. First, you will need to get a test tone to do this with. You can use the YouTube link in the description for a good long 80 Hertz test tone that you can play while you run your test. If you set your crossover with your main speakers to something other than 80 Hertz, then use a YouTube test tone that matches your crossover frequency, as our goal is to match the phase of our main speakers and subwoofers where they're both playing the same frequency. Here's the process for one subwoofer. Set your home theater receiver or processor to play stereo. Now sit in your primary chair and start up the test tones. Make a note of the SPL you're getting. Then slowly increase the distance in 1 foot increments and stop where you get the highest SPL measurement. If your subwoofer does not have digital processing, the maximum SPL will likely be at approximately the actual distance from the sub. If your subwoofer has digital processing, the SPL will be highest somewhere between the actual distance and about 12 feet extra, which would correlate with a 12 millisecond delay. If this got too techy and it's easier for you to read what I'm saying, then click on the link in the description to go to our full written article on what I'm talking about. Once you've set your subwoofer distance, you're done. For two subwoofers, how you do this will depend on your home theater receiver or processor. There are a few possible combinations. For those of you using a Y connector for two subs and neither sub has a variable phase or an app. Just do the same steps as I described above if they are both on the front wall. If one is in front and one in the rear has a 0 to 180 phase switch. Try it in both spots to see which gives you the most output. If you have subs with an app or variable phase that are connected with a Y connector, do one sub first, preferably the one furthest away from you, using the distance control on your home theater receiver, then add the second sub and change its phase until you get the highest level recording. If you have two subs with no adjustments, but your receiver or processor has independent distances, follow the same steps, just using the distance instead of phase knobs for each one. For those of you with four subwoofers, it is highly likely you have a home theater receiver or processor that has Dirac or Anthem room correction, and it will do all of the phase adjustments for you. At this point, it is a good idea to write down the distances you came to when setting phase, as some receivers will get them wrong in the next step. Now that the subwoofers are set up properly, if your home theater receiver or processor does not have any kind of room correction, simply go back through the test tones and balance out all of your speakers to 75 dB with the combined level of all your subs at 75 dB. If your receiver or processor does have room correction, follow its steps now. Unless your receiver or processor has phase alignment like Dirac or Anthem room correction, you'll need to go back in after it is done and change the distance or distances for your sub or subwoofers you noted after the phase calibration. Our experience tells us some systems get this phase wrong. I also suggest you take a look at our tips on calibrating your center channel speaker we have in the link below and run through them after these steps are finished. That concludes my tips on subwoofer setup. I hope this video was helpful and brought your home theater up a notch or two. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to reach out to us at audioadvice.com via chat, email, phone, or drop by one of our North Carolina showrooms. If you enjoyed this video, like and subscribe to get all the latest information on home theaters and audio. Again, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.